Ooh, buddy, there it is. The M1 Mac Mini has finally arrived after about a month of waiting. Man, this thing took forever to get here. So the big question is, am I going to keep this guy? And I think, yeah, I think I'm going to keep it because A, I think it's going to be better than the machine I got, and B, I'm a little worried. What happens if my 2015 MacBook Pro decides to die on me? That wouldn't be good. So excited to get this guy opened up, get her set up, and try it out, kind of see how it's working. Especially curious on how well it's going to do in DaVinci Resolve. So we're going to go ahead, get this guy going. I'm going to show you the process of just migrating my stuff from my old machine to this one, kind of see how that works out. And no, it didn't come like this. It was in another box, but I already opened it up just to make sure everything was good to go. It was there, it was the right model, and all that kind of stuff. So let's jump back down into the studio. We're going to get this guy set up, and I'll just show you guys the process of what I do to get it going. All right, so we got the new M1 Mac Mini, the 16 gigabyte version here. And now we're gonna unbox this guy, open it up, and just try and get everything from my old computer onto this computer. So there's a lot of different ways that you can do it. I'm gonna try starting with the migration assistant and migrate just some of the things because I want it to be a pretty clean transfer of my stuff. I don't wanna bring like any of the garbage that's on my other computer onto here. So I'm gonna just kind of run through that migration assistant. I'll show you that. And we'll see how that works out. So hopefully I can bring some things like contacts and things like that, but not bring programs and all that, because I'll just download programs that are, you know, set up for the M1 here. We're gonna get going on that. Let's open this guy up and get it out of the box here. I'm surprised the weight of this thing. It's actually a lot heavier than I thought it would be. There you go. And that's it. There it is. We're gonna take off the little cover here. Mac Mini, small. Nice little cover on all the ports here. Got our little instruction book or whatever right here. Got our power cord, and that's pretty much all that it comes with, right? So we're gonna hook this up to the monitor that I have. I have an LG widescreen that you guys have probably seen in other videos too. So that's what I'm gonna be using for this Mac Mini here. And just to check out the instructions, because I always recommend checking out the instructions, make sure you're doing everything right. We'll just look at this real quick, make sure we plug her in, get everything set up right, then we're gonna fire it up and see what we can do for the migration assistant here. All right, so just to show you guys my setup a little bit here, got my old MacBook Pro right here. That's what I'm gonna be transferring to this guy right here. My 34-inch LG widescreen monitor, and then I have an old Mac keyboard I'm gonna use for now, as well as the same mouse I was using on my MacBook Pro. So I'm gonna put the Mac Mini down over here with where my computer was before. By the way, it's out of the way, and I'm really looking forward to actually this running quiet, because my MacBook Pro over here, when that guy runs, man, those fans turn on and it's blazing and it's loud. So I'm gonna set this Mac Mini over here. We're gonna hook it up, and then we're gonna get going and see what we could do here. Ooh, that's nice. Got my monitor. I'm just gonna hook this up with HDMI for now. And I've also got my keyboard here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and plug that in on this guy for right now, and that should be just fine. All right, so we're gonna fire this guy up. I'm gonna turn it on, see what we get, and we're gonna go from there. So here's how I'm gonna set up the new Mac Mini. Hey, check that out, it talks to you. How about that? So right now it's asking me to connect up to the Wi-Fi because that's how these two computers are gonna talk to each other through the Wi-Fi. So I'm gonna go ahead and hook that up. Data and privacy, we're good on that. So here's what it says. Do you wanna transfer your information from a Mac, Time Machine backup, or startup disk? So I'm going from a Mac. Continue, select a Mac, Time Machine, or other startup disk. So I do need to jump onto my other Mac now and open the migration assistant. So let's check that out. So we're gonna come down to applications, utilities, migration assistant, continue. So now it looks like it's getting it all set up. So we want to transfer to another Mac. Okay, now since we're connected there, over here on this Mac, we can see my MacBook Pro, Focus's MacBook Pro came up. So now we're gonna jump in there and we're gonna choose MacBook Pro. Now they're going to show little codes here on the screen and make sure that this Mac is going to that Mac and it's a good secure connection. So that looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and hit continue on the MacBook Pro. And then it's going to look for information that I can transfer over. And the other thing too is I don't know how long it's going to take to do all this. So we're going to just let it run once we select the things that we want to transfer over and hit go. We're going to see how long that's going to take. All right, so on the new Mac Mini here, it does look like it popped up a bunch of options for us. So if I take a look here, we can see that it's got applications and different things in there. So I'm just gonna take a look through these and see what I wanna transfer, select the things that I want, and then we're gonna go ahead and start that process. So here we go, let's check this out and see what we can do here. So while this is taking its time to kind of round everything up, some of the reasons why I decided to keep this M1, I was just worried that what if my MacBook Pro dies before I'm able to get, you know, one of the next generation, the M1Xs or whatever it might be. What if it dies before then? That could be a real pain in the butt, especially since it took a month for this one to come. Like, that's a long time, right? Because for me, I'm not going to go buy the base models that you can get in the stores and all that. I'm going to upgrade the RAM as much as I can. The storage, I'm just going to make sure that it's, you know, at least a terabyte, because I think anything smaller than that for me and my workflow might be a little bit difficult. So all those extra ones, it always seems like you got to special order them or have them just, you know, ordered online and then sent to you. And that's kind of a pain that you can't just buy those in the store. At least from my experience, the ones that I want, you can't just get it in the store. So I don't want to have to wait another month if something goes wrong with this MacBook Pro. That's the main reason that I'm keeping this, as well as once school starts in the fall, if for any reason, you know, my kiddo's got to do virtual again, we do need another computer, and the Chromebooks from the school are probably no good. At least I'll have this extra MacBook Pro that I can use. But for the meantime, I'll probably use both back and forth a little bit, make sure I get everything set up. It works good. Most importantly, I'm looking forward to working with the photos and the videos on this new M1 to see how well does it work compared to my 2015 MacBook Pro. I assume it's going to be better. I hope it's good enough that I'm happy with it. And then, like, you know, you can do some fusion and all that stuff. So hopefully it's going to be enough to last me a while until maybe another generation or two of, you know, the M whatever chips come out and more GPU power and all that kind of stuff. I don't know. We'll see what happens. All right, let me jump back and check this out, and hopefully we can get this going here. So it looks like libraries automatically brought over the ADLM. I don't know what that is. So we'll bring that. Applications, I'm not going to bring that. I'll just download them new. The Creative Cloud files from Adobe, don't need that. My desktop stuff, I'll just clean that up on my old one. I don't need most of that stuff. My documents, I do want to bring those over. Downloads, I don't care about that. Dropbox and Google Drive, you can just download them and it'll sync everything back up. Movies, I'm not sure what I got in there. I don't think it's too much. I probably don't even need to bring that. The music, I'll bring that so that way it's on this machine. Pictures, I'm not bringing that. Notice that's huge because when I'm working on my photography files, I will generally put them on my hard drive, edit them, and then move them off onto an external drive. Public, that's just a whole bunch of personal, you know, documents and Excel files and all that kind of stuff. And then other data, I'm not sure what that is either. I really don't want to bring a ton of junk, which is almost why I was thinking about not doing it this way. Then you've got other files and folders, as well as system and network here. So I think I'll leave that stuff checked. And set a password so that this computer can access that computer, no problem. You agree to some terms and conditions here, because if you don't, you can't do anything anyway. So now it's got a little message that popped up here that it's transferring from my MacBook Pro to this new Mac Mini. And on the MacBook Pro, it tells me it's looking for files and transferring stuff. So we're gonna go ahead and let this run for a while, then I'll be back once that's all done. We'll see how it did and move from there, and then we'll get this guy up and running. Check it out, we'll see you guys in a little bit. All right, so the migration got complete there, and we just restarted. Now it says migration complete. So we should be good to go to get this guy running. That's it, we're logging in. Let's try this bad boy out. So it looks like I'm gonna go through now and download the rest of my programs, the Adobe stuff, DaVinci Resolve, ScreenFlow, and a couple other things. I mean, I don't have too much stuff on my MacBook Pro that I actually need, a lot of old junk and stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and download those. We're gonna get that done, and then we start working on this guy, see how it works out. All right, guys, so I've been working on this new Mac Mini for about 2 weeks now, and I have to say it's been working out really well. I've had no issues with it. Migrating everything over was no big deal. Downloading the programs, all that, no big deal. Everything worked out great. It's running Big Sur. Did any updates that I needed to. It's been working out just fine. DaVinci Resolve has been working great. Blackmagic Design did release 17.3, which was more optimized for the Mac M1, where they said it was up to 3 times faster. And I mean, I just haven't experienced any lagging at all in DaVinci Resolve, which is awesome. Cause my other MacBook Pro, it would lag a little bit, you know, nothing crazy, I could deal with it, but it's really nice to not have those little pauses and delays. So anytime it's rendering stuff in the background here, it goes pretty quick. And I really gotta say, I mean, it's nice to be able to edit a little bit smoother. And I did expect it to be better than my MacBook Pro, obviously, because my MacBook Pro is 6 years old, so it's showing its age a little bit. So I have edited a bunch of videos already on this M1. You've seen them on my channel, although you didn't know they came from the M1, but I did. I have to say the export times much quicker than on my old 2015 MacBook Pro. That's a bonus. I don't have to wait. You know, this thing's done in no time. If you guys are interested in a little comparison between how long it takes on my 2015 MacBook Pro and how long it takes on the Mac Mini to export a project, leave a comment down below, let me know, and maybe I can make some videos that kind of show you the differences there. But overall, I am happy that I kept this M1. It's made my job a lot easier, made things move smoother and quicker. The effects and transitions and stuff like that, when you drop them on, they just work. You don't have to wait for anything to render like I did in my 2015 MacBook Pro. Now remember, that computer was loaded, it was maxed out. But nowadays, you know, it's 6 years old, so it's definitely showing its age. And I didn't get to edit any photos on there yet because I'm still trying to go through all the photos on the MacBook Pro, which you can see, still got it over here, you know, keeping it on my desk. And then I use that to kind of float around, you know, if I want to go work upstairs or something like that, I'll still use it because it's great for everything else other than, you know, the video editing where it's showing its age a little bit. So I will get to editing photos on there. If you're interested in that, comment below. I'll let you know how that works out. But I imagine that it's going to do better than, you know, my MacBook Pro did. Anyways, so how quiet is this thing? Well, when I'm filming videos, you don't hear anything. I still have it down over here, right? Down over there, and it's not making any noise. I mean, I haven't heard it make any noise. I actually have my Drobo over there, which is, if you don't know what that is, it's a 5-bay, kind of like a RAID system, but that's got a fan in the back, so I hear that running. So I'm happy that you don't hear anything coming out of the Mac Mini. Now, what about ports? I know a lot of people are worried about, I don't got enough ports. Well, for me, it really hasn't been a problem. I do have a big USB 3 dongle thing here. So I use that to plug a lot of stuff into, and that works out just fine. Also on the back of my monitor here, I do have a bunch of USB, actually two USB-C inputs where I can plug in stuff there. And then I just run a USB-C from my monitor down to the computer, and then that works out fine. So that's an extra two ports there. And since I'm using this old school Mac keyboard here, another cool thing is it's got two USB ports on either side of the keyboard. So like I can plug my mouse into here, you know, I don't worry about the Bluetooth stuff. I know people have had Bluetooth issues with this Mac Mini. I don't really use the Bluetooth with it, at least at this point in time. I just plug in what I got because that's what I got, and I didn't feel like going to buy anything else. And it works fine. I've had no problems with any of those devices being connected. So got no problem with that. But all in all, I think it was a good decision to keep this. It does speed up my workflow. It's going to last me for a while, at least until, you know, the next round of the M1Xs or whatever they call them are going to come out, you know, maybe in another year or two. Wait till a generation or two goes through. We'll see where the computer world is at that point in time. But for now, it seems like this is going to be enough power to get the job done for me. Now, I did try out Fusion a little bit. Now, I don't do heavy Fusion work because my other computer couldn't do it. So I just haven't done much of it yet. So I'm looking forward to getting in that a little more. We did do a recent tutorial about the lockdown stabilization effect, link above if you haven't checked that out yet. But that just ran flawlessly, no problems here on the M1. It ran like a piece of cake, no problem. That is it for this video, guys. So I'm gonna get back to work here, finish up my brew, make some more videos for you guys, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.